Mighty power. And God has come with his power to bless everybody here today. God will surely give you a miracle in the name of Jesus. I know you all have come with great expectations. How many of us have great expectations from the Lord? You want something special from God, something, a tangible miracle in your life. Let me see you. Wave your hands and give you, I will give you a tangible miracle. A wonderful miracle. You want something tangible from the Lord? God will give you that tangible miracle in Jesus' name. I say God will give you a tangible miracle tonight in Jesus' name. I'm not going to take your time at all. All I want to tell you is that you can put down your hands. I want you to get ready for your miracle. God is present here with his power. The man of God is here from Lagos with the power of the living God. And the men here tonight, the women here tonight, the old, the young, educated, illiterate, there's a miracle for everybody. And there's a miracle for you too. Whatever may be your problems, God is here.
I bow your head so we can pray before we start. Father, we thank you for this time. I'm asking that by your spirit you reveal yourself to everyone. Show us the way to the presence of the Father. In Jesus' name, we pray.
Amen. I want to talk to you tonight about a very serious problem. Very, very serious in the lives of men. I'm going to talk to you as a teacher. Later I will minister to you as an evangelist. I have a great burden in my heart because of a serious problem in human life. I hope you know that Adam is the name of the person that was first created. Then Eve was created. Here we have this first family. Adam and Eve.
Adam and Eve.
They were together. God placed them in the Garden of Eden. This was the place. Anytime he wanted, he came to meet them. He supplied all their needs. There was no need in that family as long as the Lord was coming to visit them. But then something happened that resulted into what we call divine discipline. And in Genesis chapter 3, I'm looking at verse 23. Therefore the Lord God sent him forth from the Garden of Eden to till the ground from whence he was taken. So he drove out the man. Think about that. Because I want to teach you tonight that man has been driven away from the presence of God. Since that time, we have been trying to find out Where is the way? The way back home. Where is the way? The way back into the presence of God. Where is the way? The way back into the power of God. Think about this. That you were born. When you were born, suppose your parents were driven out of your village. And then you have been in the world, roaming about, not knowing your root or your source, not knowing where you came from. And here you are now. You have been asking about, where is the way? To our home. Where is the way? To the place I came. And nobody can show you the way. Here you are. You have no root. You've lost your means, your family line. Here you are. You've lost everything. And you have been roaming about, asking the question, where is the way? Adam was driven out. Eve was driven out. The Bible says, so he drove out the man. Then the firstborn came. That was the firstborn of Adam and Eve. Again, do you know that this firstborn had to be driven out? Again, from the presence of God. Again, from the power of God. In Genesis chapter 4, verse 14, behold, thou hast driven me out this day. Since the time of Adam and Eve, since the time of their firstborn, the question that has been in the heart of man, in the heart of the woman, is where is the way? Abel too was born. Where is the way? To the presence of God. To serve God. To please God. And then we have Noah. Noah again started finding out. Our forefathers had forsaken God. They had been driven out. Again, where is the way? Multitudes of that time, thousands and millions of people, they did not find that way. They died and washed. They were washed away in the flood. Do you remember Lot? Where is the way? He never found the right way. That's why he went to Sodom. And his property got burned. You know Moses? He was looking for the way. Where is the way? You know the children of Israel? When they came out of Egypt, wanted to go to the land of promise. Where is the way? Who would lead us? Who will go before us? Do you know that the children of Israel, even when they settled in the land of Canaan, this question never left them. Where is the way? All through the Bible, man has been searching. Where is the way? You know, when we are born, we begin to search. You want to find a career. What are you going to do? What are you asking? Where is the way? When you are growing up, now you have studied, you have passed out of school, now what career are you going to, profession you are going to settle in? You know what you are asking? Where is the way? You want to get married, and you are running up and down. Some people are checking up for the blood of this, the group blood of this, the blood of this other person, so you can find out whether they match together or not. You know what they are finding out? Where is the way? Men and women, we start walking. Again, we're finding out. I want to know what the future holds for me. Because man is afraid. He knows he has lost his way. He's trying to find out every time, where is the way? And this is how we
we have been roaming up and down.
Men
and women. Until this very time, there are people who are not very sure. Where is the way back to the presence of God?
Oh,
some people say when you get saved, everything is finished. You have not found the way. Well, partly. But you know, after you are saved, and you begin to find some trouble in your life. Oppression, the destruction of the devil, and you find this opposition in life, you're not able to get your work, your business all together, and there is sickness in your body, even as a believer, you're asking again, where is the way into healing? You know, the believer is always praying, and he says, I'm looking for the will of God. You know what he's asking for? He's asking for the way. Way back to the place we love. And that is why you need to consider that problem today. Where is the way into the presence of God? Where is the way into the peace of God? Where is the way into power to overcome in your life? Now in Ecclesiastes chapter 10, I want to read a verse of scripture to you there. And I told you, I want to really teach you before I pray for you as an evangelist. Because many people, they have missed their way. They have lost their way. And they are not able to get into the presence of God. Since Adam and Eve had been driven away from the presence of God, we have all been roaming about trying to find out which way. Have you ever traveled out to a place like Lagos? Now, you had the contact address in Lagos before. Your uncle that you ought to see. You thought the address was still in your box. You got to Lagos. You dropped out of the vehicle. You checked up in your box. You lost the address. You only remember the name of your uncle. You can't remember the street. You can't remember the place. You can't remember the location. You can't remember the place of work. You can't remember anything about him except his name. Then you go this way. You say, where is Mr. So and so? They said they have never heard of his name. You got into another taxi. I think it's Ajegunle. Where in Ajegunle? You paid about 20 naira to the taxi driver. He dropped you. Then you think, I think I heard about the name Surulere before. You got another taxi. You go to Surulere. You paid another 25 naira. Your money is now exhausted. Your strength is exhausted. Your food is exhausted. You are tired, you are worn out. You are confused, you know nothing. Night is coming now. The armed robbers are after you. Here you have a box with some money still in the box, with your property in the box. There is no place to lodge. You can't find your uncle. What are you going to do? And you are asking, if something will come from this car and show me the way, I can locate this man. Because until I locate him, I cannot trust. Here you are in the world. God created you. Not just in Lagos. Here you are in the whole world. Which direction are you going to follow? You go this way. They take your money. You go that way. They take all your attention. They say there is no way there. Then you go this way. Again, there is no way there. You go this way. Again, there is no way there. What are you going to do? You are now exhausted. You are now tired. You're looking up to the sky. If somebody will come down and show me the way. Because if you continue your life like this, what God created you for, you have not even month started. This man that got to Lagos, he has not even settled down. No friend. The only uncle he has in this world, in that Lagos, is nowhere to be found. There is no friend. There is no helper. There is no supporter. There is no house. There is no way to go. He is a confused man. And the armed robbers are after him. And if they discover that he doesn't have a place to rest, he is in trouble. His life is in danger. Where you are in the world, Satan is after you. I can tell you that. The evil spirits are after you. I can tell you that. Wicked people are after you. And I can tell you that. And there is no shelter. There is no accommodation. There is no helper. You are alone in the world. Your poor father Adam was driven out of the presence of God. The firstborn was driven out of the presence of God. In the farm, there is no peace. In the house, there is no peace. You put your portmanteau down. The certificate that these people of the world in the schools gave to you, put it down because it was nothing. You begin to ask the question, where is the way? Then you begin to go about. You ask the herbalist, where is the way? He says, I don't know, but I can only guess. Try this one. I myself have not got out of the wood, out of the wilderness. But try this one. You try that one, you are deeper in the trouble that you got before. Then you hear about a prayer house, spiritual people. Maybe they will know the way. You go there again and you say, I am looking for the way. Since I was born, my hand cannot reach my head. My hand cannot put something in my mouth. I cannot make two ends of my life meet. I am married. I don't understand myself. I don't understand my wife. I don't understand my in-laws. We're roaming about. I've been in that place of work. I've been in that place of work. I don't understand my life or myself. When I sleep at night, some people drive me, they run after me. I run and run and run. I see the house I want to enter. When I get near, the house goes further. When I get near, the house gets further. When am I going to enter into rest? Help me. Then again, they read psalms for you. They put some incantation. They make some sacrifice. Again, after some time, there's still the confusion. You say, where will I go? And you came here tonight. Every time you hear that a man of God is coming to town, a man of God from America, a man of God from Lagos, a man of God from Africa, a man of God from anywhere, you go there. Maybe this time, this man of God will show me the way. Because we are looking for the way. Here we are. As human beings, perplexed, troubled, confused, roaming about, there is no settlement. And the years are going. The one that was 21 years before, maybe he's now 30, and he's counting the days, and he's saying, when will I settle down in life? I said, if I get married, things will become better. I am married, and the evil spirits are pursuing me. Well, it's because I'm a businessman that is why they are pursuing me. Let me become, now that they are talking about agriculture, let me become a farmer. You are a farmer and the troubles are more. They say it's because that you are a human being, an adult, you didn't take into a secret cult and hide yourself there. You joined the secret cult. Since you joined secret cult, my friend, how is it now? You found a way? Where is the way? Where are we going?
Akanmu. Where are we coming from?
Itomo.
If we die now,
Itomo.
Think about if you die now,
Itomo.
What have you done in this world?
Itomo.
Since you came
Itomo.
To this world,
Itomo.
Have you got satisfaction?
Itomo.
Have you got peace?
Itomo.
Have you settled down?
Itomo.
Are you happy you were created?
Itomo.
When are we going to stop running?
Itomo.
This enemy pursuing us.
Itomo.
This devil running after us.
Itomo.
Running and running and running.
Itomo.
And there is no house I can hide myself.
Itomo.
Human beings are in trouble.
Itomo.
Where is the way?
Itomo.
Can somebody show us the way?
Itomo.
Look at Ecclesiastes chapter 10.
Ecclesiastes.
And in verse 15. Ecclesiastes chapter 10.
Verse 15.
The labor of the foolish wearies every one of them, because he knoweth not how to go to the city. That's our problem. We do not know how to get to the place of rest. And that is why human beings were running up and down. We're going to and fro. And the labor of the foolish. The labor of the foolish. Who is a foolish man? Think about it. If both myself and my brother, if we were at school, he wanted to become a doctor. I wanted to become a doctor. He was lucky for somebody to show him the way, the subjects to take, the exams to take. And now he has made it, he has become a doctor. Myself too, I wanted to become a doctor. I did not have somebody to show me the way, and I took the wrong exam, and I went in the wrong direction, and I could not become a doctor. He has been wise. I have been foolish. I labored. I didn't get it. The labor of the foolish makes him tired. He does not know how to get into the city. Here we are, two people. I'm trying to get married. He is trying to get married. Somebody showed him the way. He married the right lady. Things are peaceful. He is now settled. They have children. His work is going. He's a happy man. He's wise. Somebody showed him the way. Here am I, trying to get married. No counselor. No advisor. No helper. Nobody to show me the way. I married somebody. Since I married, it's all tears. Since I married, it's all sorrow. Since I married, my life is being torn into pieces. I have been foolish. The labor of the foolish wearies every one of them. Here are two people. They're trying to get into business. They have capital. They have money. Looking at them, they look like they have equal resources. This other person trying to get into business. Somebody showed him the way. Somebody led him through. He went on and on. His capital multiplied. His business progressed. He is a wise man. Here am I. I jumped into that business. All the money I have, all the reserves I have, I put into that business. The business collapsed. The capital is gone. I am left empty. Enemies are mocking me. They are saying, look at him. He thinks that is how to do business. He ran into it without knowing the way. The man that doesn't know the way is a foolish man. The man that doesn't know the way is the one that everybody will be making fun of. Have we not been foolish? Where we're running about, we want peace. Where do we go? We go to the devil. For the devil,
Satan.
The one that is bringing confusion, the champion of confusion, we go to him. We say we want peace. Some people run to the river. The river that is always stormy, always bringing up waves and storms. The fish in the river, they never have peace. They are always running away from fishermen, running away from the storm, running away from the crocodile. We go in.
going there, we say it's the fish God that will give us peace. Are we not foolish? Some other people will go to the juju worshippers. The juju worshippers themselves, if you have time to talk to them and say juju worship, we are human beings. Let's forget profession. That you are idol worshippers. I'm a office worker. Let's talk to one another as man to man. You are juju worshipper. Does the devil ever trouble you? Do you ever come across witches and wizards as a juju worshipper? Is your wife ever in trouble? This God of the river, do they ever trouble you? Is it only the ordinary people they trouble? The juju worshipper will tell you, the closer you get to the devil, the hotter the fire burns. Nobody is at peace. The wife of the herbalist himself is dying prematurely. They too, they are having miscarriage. That same juju man is being chased about in his own dream. They have not left him alone. Look at how foolish we are. The juju man that is in trouble himself, we run to him. We say, Papa, deliver me. Papa cannot deliver himself. Cannot deliver his wife, killing goat, going to the sea, making sacrifice, has not delivered Papa himself. See how foolish we are, that we go to waste our money. See how foolish we are. We say, my children, they don't know good. I want to send them to university. Then I go to Papa, say, sitting somewhere. Look at Papa that is sitting somewhere. Give him newspaper. He puts it upside down. Papa does not know book. He's going to make medicine for your own child to know book. His own children, they can't go to primary school. His own children, they cannot get education. And it is Papa whose children themselves are illiterate. It is the same Papa that will make medicine for you, for your children to go to university. How foolish we are. I know that once you are alive, I will have children. How many children does Papa have? So why? He's barren. He doesn't have money for operation. Papa, the idol worshipper, has been begging the mommy water spirit to leave his wife alone so that the woman will get belle for all these years. The witches and the wizards, they have not had the pleading of Papa for himself. They will have the pleading of Papa for you. You are wasting your money. The labor of the foolish wearies every one of them. We're looking for the way. I went to London. When I got down in London, the man that came to meet me at the airport, the medical doctor.
Doctor.
The wife is a medical doctor.
What is them for the doctor?
They have been married for some time.
Boy, don't talk, hey, do
there is no child.
Hey, you need, eh?
And here am I.
They say me.
I have not studied medicine.
I mean,
but I know the way.
They
into the peace of God.
They need,
I know the way.
They need,
into the power of God.
They need,
and when he was talking with me, I started talking to this doctor, white man.
They need,
he picked me from the airport. His wife was waiting at home for me. Do you know? We went on and on and on and on. The Nigerian brother in his own car that was following us behind. Because we were just going on a particular road. I did not know the road to his own house. He himself, he had missed the way to his own house. So the Nigerian brother following us, he trafficked, then he stopped in front of us. He said, doctor, look
at the way you are taking. Have you not missed the way to your house? The doctor said, I forgot myself. The man of God that came from Nigeria, when he was telling me testimony, I forgot to look at the road. That's why we missed the way to our house. That man,
doctor,
has suffered in his life. And I started telling him the way back home, the way back to the Father, the way back into the power of God. He forgot the way. In
Lagos,
somebody gave testimony just yesterday. This woman that suffered, like a foolish woman, not knowing the way. Listen to me. If the devil is troubling you, injection cannot affect devil. See, a person that has an evil spirit going about in the head, going about in the stomach, and then you go to the doctor, the doctor examines you and begins to talk Oyibo.
Oyibo
cannot drive out the devil, and then they give you injection, and the doctor says, you're okay, you're, is that how they get okay? And you give him large amount of money. They inject you here. The devil runs there. They put you something here. The devil runs to the back. They put hot water bottle in your back. The devil runs to the neck. The devil running about. Just playing inside your body. Making fun. That is in the ear today. It's in the stomach tomorrow. And you are going all about. And all the time you are going about, the devil is making fun. He looks like a foolish human being. He does not know the way. That's why I came this week. I came to show you the way. The way back to the Father. The way back to his very presence. The way back into the power of God. This woman that was giving testimony yesterday, the doctors all they met on her, and they decided that she will die. The doctors didn't know the way. They examined her. They tried. They did everything possible. And they decided, we're sorry, madam. They told the husband. They say, husband, we're sorry. It's an impossible case. She will die. And then just 2 weeks ago, the husband and the wife, they heard about Deeper Life Bible Church. And they came. When they entered, the devil troubled the woman again. Troubled her. The pain, even when they entered, the pain was so much. The woman was wondering, will I die in this church? Then I preached. Then I told them I want to pray. And it's good to have somebody who knows the way. Somebody who can take your hand and say, you have wandered enough. Bring your hand. Let's go. This is the way. I know the way to pray. The way to get right into the presence of God and get you delivered. And I pray. Oh, God is wonderful. God is wonderful. Instantaneously, she became delivered. She went back to the doctor on Friday. Getting to the doctor. The doctor had not examined her. Just seen her like this, the doctor shouted. The doctor was surprised. The doctor said, what happened to you? The woman said, don't talk it. I want you to examine me. The doctor brought all the instruments out, examined her. Before, they said a part of the heart was no more functioning. Then there were other complications. The doctor put all the instruments down. The doctor sat down. The doctor said, now you tell me, how did it happen? Your heart is all right. Your blood is all right. You are perfectly all right. Then the doctor said, woman, show me the way. Me the way. And the woman said, it's in our Deeper Life Church. The doctor said, take me there. I am looking for the way.
I mean, you
see, There was a man that came to see me. Medical doctor. And his wife is a white woman. The man himself is Nigerian. And he is in charge of a hospital. And this woman, when she was seeing me, English woman, real white woman, the tears were coming down. Because the husband being a doctor, if they give any medicine to her in the body, the body will react against the medicine. She was sick. She couldn't sleep. She was perplexed. Here she was in Nigeria. She had married in Nigeria. And there is no peace. And she was telling me, this man loves me. He will give me everything I want. But there is no peace. There is no help. I am dying of. Pastor, help me. Thank God we have the help. Thank God we have the help. Some people came from America. Black Americans. They came to this Nigeria to do business. And what they never saw before in the whole of the world. The power of evil spirit. Black American. They began to see real juju power. That woman told me, two of them, that they went into an office like this. Just before they entered, flies covered them completely. She had an appointment with a boss or manager at 10 o'clock. She was standing outside the office, taking away all the flies until the time of the appointment went. Then her driver took her to a white garment church. Black American began to ask for holy water to wash her body. Looking for the way. And the trouble continued. And there was no deliverance. Eventually she heard that there is a place called Deeper Life Bible Church. Thank God we know the way. Thank God we know the way. And those two women came. They told me their story. I smiled. And I told them, your deliverance is near. I prayed for them. And a miracle happened. You know what they did? They went to the embassy in Nigeria. They went to bring the ambassador to introduce him to me. They said, ambassador, anybody that has problems that came from our country, this man can help them. It's good to know the way. Because you know, if you're just in this world, you don't know the way. There is no peace. There is no healing. You're spending all your money. You're going to the abalis. You're going to the jujuma. You're going to the idols. You're making sacrifice. There is no way there. You think about it. You have made sacrifices now for 10 years. Are you better now? You have made sacrifices to Mami Water Spirit. Oh, they said, just beg them. Somebody you beg for 1 year will sacrifice. You put idol in the house and you are begging this Mami Water. You beg and beg and beg. After you have begged this Mami Water for 5 years, anytime you miss that sacrifice, come and see the trouble at night. And then you rise up again. You say, Mami Water, I beg you for all this years. Give you all my money, all my food, all the sacrifice. Just because I missed the sacrifice for 1 week, look at how you are troubling me, Mami Water. This is the world in which we are. But if somebody can show you the way and take you by the hand, lead you right into the presence of the Almighty God, all your sorrow will be over. All your problem will be over. And that is why I've been going about from city to city, finding people who are fed up with their foolishness, who say, now I even want to settle down.
Please, turn the cassette over.
discover where is the way.
And here we are tonight,
as you are asking, where is the way? Where is the way? And I call that you might know, that you might find out, this is the way. Then it will come to your tongue to accept, to walk in that way. Because if I show you and you make up your mind that you are sorry, that you will still be wasting your money with the idol worship, who can help you again? If you decide, you will still be worshipping the money water spirit, as I have shown you the way, who can help you again? If I show you the way, and you say, no, I will continue in all my wicked ways away from the presence of God. If you reject the help of God, who will show you the way again? I've met people from many, many areas of life. University students. There was at Ilorin, in Kwara State. I went for miracle service there. There was a young girl, you know, from ladies who don't understand this world in which we're living. God have mercy on the ignorant. If you're ignorant in this world and you don't discover the way, that man will suffer. That woman will suffer. This lady, a university lady, she slept at night. While she was sleeping, a snake came to bite her in the hand. That hand became paralyzed when she woke up. And she had been carrying that paralyzed hand away just about. And then she's now in university studying psychology. And then I went to Kwara State. I was preaching, and that lady, she said that man is just using psychology on the people. That's what she felt. You know, young girls who don't understand life, who think, you know, their facial appearance, their beauty is the only thing in life, who feel just going to university. University. You come out.
What are they?
The devil is outside here. He's waiting. You better find the way back to the presence of God. So she was making fun. Oh, she said they call him man of God. That this person they call man of God, that all that is preaching to them is just psychology.
Then
we started to pray. She didn't close her eyes. She said that is all psychology. Thank God for the mercy of God. And I began to pray for those who are paralyzed. As I was praying for those who are paralyzed, the power of God touched that hand that was laid. No, she said, no, my hand, that is psychology. No, I don't agree. Oh, thank God for the mercy of God. She slept at night, that very night. She had a dream. Force came out of the hand. When she woke up in the morning, the hand was as perfect as the other. Then the mother took her. Took her to a friend of a Indipalai Bible Church. And began to give testimony. Then she started to believe that it is not psychology. It is the power of God. And I came here to show you the power of God. That God will deliver you. That God will show you the way. Out of the worship of the devil. Out of the devil. Out of the worship of a man. You know, there are people in this world. And there are people in this place. They want to find the way. Maybe they were in the Anglican church before. They had no peace. Oh, they felt there is no way there. Maybe they crossed to another church. Perhaps celestial church. Then they felt maybe there is no way there. Then they hear the name of a particular man. Oh, and they feel if I go there, that will solve my problem. They get in there. They find again there is no way there. And now you have come here today and you say, I will try this one. now you are not trying this one. This one is the way. This is the truth. This is the life. And I found many, many people. I've shown them the way. They have come out of their darkness, out of their sin, out of their problems, and the power of the Almighty God has delivered them. I have gone to various places. I went to a particular place and I was preaching. When I finished the preaching, a woman that had been a witch, she ran to me and she began to beg, saying, "Please, have mercy on me." I said, "What's the matter?" She said, "I should forgive her." I said, "But what's the matter?" She said, "The fire of God is burning her." I said, "Why?" She said, "Because she tried to go against me." Well, I said, "You tried? Don't try. I'm a servant of God. God sent me, and I prayed for her, and eventually she became delivered." There was a man in Lagos that had juju power, real bad power. And in their juju call, they decided that they were going to harm me. You don't try it. When you try it on somebody who doesn't know the way, you know, somebody who is just preaching for commercial purpose, preaching to get money, you can catch those people. But when you meet a real man of God, you touch him, you touch trouble. You touch him, you get into fire. And this man, he tried. They sent a particular woman to first try. That woman came to my church wanting to destroy me. The woman got converted and became born again and became a member of the church. So this other man came, said, "I will do it myself." And that man came again. The power of God arrested him. He's now a member of my church. He's born again. All those juju power, everything has totally gone. I'm telling you something. When you know the way, all the powers of evil spirits, they are gone away from you. When you know the way, all the powers of evil men, they are gone away from you. But the Bible says, the labor of the foolish wearies every one of them, because he knoweth not how to go into the city. You want to know the way? You want to stop beating about the bush? You want to get right into the presence of God? Look at John chapter 1 if you have your Bible there. I'm looking at verse 38. Then Jesus turned and saw them following and says unto them, "What seek ye?" They said unto him, "Rabbi," which is to say, being interpreted, "Master, where dwellest thou?" Where is the way? He says unto them, "Come and see." If you're asking where is the way into the power of God, my answer to you is, come and see. If you don't have peace in your life and you are asking the question, where is the way? My answer to you is, come and see. If you are looking for a miracle in your life, you want to have the power of God destroying the power of Satan in your life, and you are asking, where is the way? My answer to you is, come and see. Jesus Christ, the way, the truth, the lie. In John chapter 14, verse 6, Jesus says unto him, "I am the way, I am the truth, I am the lie. No man cometh unto the Father but by me." If you really want to know God and the power of God, there is only one way. And God has appointed me to declare that Jesus Christ
is that way? And is that true? And is that life? And as you come to the Lord, coming through the sacrifice of Jesus Christ, no more killing animals, no more making juju, no more serving spirit, no more worshipping any other thing but just God in the name of Jesus. As you come, coming out of your sin, coming out of your evil, saying now, I come. I want to come to the Lord, because you have discovered the way. The Lord will deliver you. All your sicknesses He will take away. All your problems He will take away. This year alone, I have seen the lame walking. I think right now there have been more than 20 this year alone. On one single day, Thursday in Lagos, one woman that had been in the wheelchair, I just removed the bandage of the devil away from her, tying her leg, and manifested the authority of the Lord Jesus Christ. She stood up out of that wheelchair and she started walking. A man that had crushes called an usher and said, "Usher, take these crutches for me." The usher took the crutches. He stood up and started walking. Many, many things the Lord has been doing, because I know the way. And that's what I come to show you. The way. The way back into the presence of God. This year, I've seen many blind eyes getting open. I've seen the deaf and the dumb hearing and speaking. Just this last week, we saw the power of God. A man that had mental problems, serious mental problems. We started that meeting, that crusade at Enugu on Monday. The people that knew him, they said he troubled the people around there on Monday, on Tuesday, on Wednesday. On Thursday, I felt the power of God so much. In the middle of the message, the people were clapping at the stadium around the place. Then I wondered what was happening. But I kept on preaching. When I finished preaching and I finished praying, then I asked the people, said, what happened when they were clapping there? Then I was told that there was a man that had serious violent mental problems. At the middle of my message, the evil spirit felt the fire of the Holy Ghost burning and flew out of the head of the man. And the man shouted and said, I am free. And the people started clapping. Then there was somebody that was blind. Just this last week at Enugu, as we prayed like this, the eyes got open, they began to see. Somebody that was deaf and dumb, and we prayed, he went back home. At 11 o'clock in the night, he just discovered he had people discussing, and then he started to reply them. He dressed up immediately and went to the deeper life person that took him to the crusade and said, look at me now, I can talk, I can hear. I went to Kaduna just some weeks ago, and there was this person, a woman, had been tormented by evil spirit, and I prayed, the Lord delivered right there. And you'll be surprised that live lizard came out of the head and came out of the body. There was a woman that gave a testimony. When she was giving the testimony like this, she was crying, because she had seen trouble in this world. And eventually on Friday night, just like today, we prayed and she got delivered. When she finished her testimony, the people could not clap. The people were wiping the tears out of their faces, because the devil had troubled that woman. Another woman that had been suffering from 1954. It was that Friday she came. And I prayed, and the Lord delivered that woman. In Kwara State, there was a woman that was bent all over. The spinal cord was totally bent. She couldn't stand up like we're standing up now. She was in the meeting. A doctor who had been treating her for many years was in that same meeting. We prayed and God delivered her. She had been in that trouble for about 15 years. Do you know that when she was giving her testimony on Saturday morning, the doctor said, "That's my patient, that's my patient." The doctor affirmed that that person was his patient and the person now had been totally killed. Many things the Lord has been doing. And I thank God because the power of God is here. If you want to be delivered, God will deliver you. If you want to be free, God will set you free. But God cannot force you. If you say, "My idol is my idol. My idol is my property. I have spent so much money on my idol, and I will remain with that idol." Good luck for you. Or if you say, "Well, I'm in a secret society, and I want to remain there. You want to remain with Satan. Waste your money. Waste your life. And not find the way into the peace of God. If you want to remain in your trouble, what can we do? We can only say, "Okay, you want to remain? That's your law." Or if you feel that you have been sacrificing, following the ways of the world, and you have not found the way, and here the man of God is here to show you the way, let me ask you, do you think that I came here tonight by accident? Do you think I came here today by accident? I'm asking you. Or you think I have no work to do? I'm less busy in Lagos. And that is why I am now here. Do you think like that? No. I came because God sent me. I came because there are many of you who have been praying before. Thank God. What have I done? Why will I continue like this? Send deliverance to me. Why am I like this? I have married. No child. I have married. There is no peace. God, what have I done? I run here, there is no peace. I run here, there is no deliverance. I go to that church, they chop my money. I go to that other place, everything is upside down. Look at my children. Look at myself. Look at my business. God, what have I done? When will you show me the way? And God has looked at your tears. God has looked at your sorrow. And he has brought this time. And here you are. And I'm telling you, this is the way. This is the way. In Jeremiah, I'm looking at chapter 6, verse 16. Thus says the Lord, "Stand ye in the ways, seek and see and ask for the old paths. Where is the good way? Walk therein, and ye shall find rest for your soul." But they said, "We will not walk there." After you have rejected, there is no way for mercy again. After you have rejected, how can you get healing when the person that God wants to use to deliver you when he has come, and you say, "No, I don't want it"? Why did you come? If you are rejecting the way, why did you come? If you are rejecting the life, why did you come? If you are rejecting all that God has provided. Now those of you that are born again, and we come like this, oh, and you say the man of God is talking to those people that are not born again. You are born again. I rejoice with you. But since you have been born again, you slept at night, You sleep well.
Since
you've been born again,
you've
been going up and down.
Are
you free from fear?
Are
you free from defeat?
In
your life? Yes, you are born again. Whether you are here in deeper life or you are there in another church, after you are born again, have you found the way into the direct, intimate relationship and presence of God that the devil cannot torment you anymore, cannot touch you anymore, and you are free, and you are free indeed. In the day or in the night, you look at the devil and he trembles.
Have
you got to that point? But I came to show you the way. If you are sick, the way into healing. If you are poor, the way into prosperity. If you are confused, the way into the peace of God. If you are weak, the way into the power of God. If you are not sanctified, the way into the holiness of God. I came to show the way. And the Bible says, thus says the Lord, stand ye. Don't stop going about. Think about it yourself. You've been going here, going there, going here, going there. Stand. Begin to think. You've gone there. What have you got? You've gone there. What have you got? You've gone there. What have you got? You are getting older. Is this the way you want to spend the rest of your life? So if you die now, will not God ask you in heaven what you did when you were in this world here? If you die now, your family is in debt, your wife is in debt, the whole family is in trouble. If you die, then the people you owe money will be troubling your wife. That's the type of death you want to die. The children are sick. If you die like this and you get to heaven, will they not be asking you questions about what you did on these people you are leaving behind? Thus says the Lord, stand ye in the ways, see for yourself, ask for the old path, and begin to ask the question, where is the good way? Stop beating about the bush. Don't be a little child that is just excited. They are calling us for religious meeting, there you go. Calling us for campaign, there you go. Calling us for this, you go. Where is the way? Find something and get into the presence of God. That's my joy. That I thank God. I'm not just, you know, running about. When I pray right to the Father God in heaven. And my prayer goes right into His presence. Many years ago, I didn't know the way. I didn't know how to pray. Many years ago, people showed me. They said, this is the way. They told me to burn candles. I burnt candles. No single prayer was answered. They told me to wear white garments. I'm talking about 26, 30 years ago. And I wore the white garment. No single prayer was heard. I read the Psalms. I rolled on the ground. I removed my shoes. I'm telling you things that I did before. I didn't know the way to the presence of God. But one day, 1963, I stood. I said, if I've been going in this direction, I didn't get deliverance all these years, I want to consider things myself. And I began to hear the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. And on the 5th of April 1964, I heard that Jesus is the way, is the truth, is the life. I looked up, I said, God, are you there? I've suffered enough. I'm not going to continue just going to church, wasting my life, just burning candles, just rolling on the ground. I want the right way. If I don't discover it, I'm going to stop every other thing. I've wasted enough time, wasted enough money on candles, wasted enough money on incense, wasted enough money on white garments. If you are there, God,
I want to find the way tonight. At about 8:15 p.m. Sunday night, 5th of April 1964, I got my way through to God. The peace of God came into my heart. The joy of God came into my heart. But after that, I still needed the way into the holiness of God. Because I discovered internally, I needed something to be uprooted and taken away. I cried. I prayed until I discovered the way of faith. The way of faith. That if I can believe, all things are possible. And I believe. And I got into the holiness experience. Then I began to search for the way to have the power of God. I heard that after you are sanctified, the power of God can so come upon you. And you'll be totally immersed and endued with the power of the Almighty God. How I thank God. On the 23rd of October 1974, that Holy Spirit, you say, from 64 to 74, I didn't see the way in time. But that day, about 10:30 in the morning, I discovered that way, and the power of God came upon me. Then I became a preacher, and I needed to find the way to pray for people, minister to the sick. There are many people. They are saved. They are children of God. They are preaching the gospel. They have not discovered the way to minister to the sick. And that is why, as a minister of the gospel, you must not rest. I'm saved. Discover the way to be able to minister to the sick and minister to the needy. I thank God. That the way is clear. Thank God that I stood. I considered. And I said, where is the good way? I hope that's the question you're asking tonight. Jesus is the way. Jesus is the truth. Jesus is the life. The Lord will deliver you tonight. If you want to be saved, if you are fed up just running around going about in sin, listen to me. I'm not preaching deeper life. I'm not saying, you know, if you're not in deeper life, you're not going to heaven. I am not talking about, I want you to come to church, but that's not the point I'm making even now. I'm talking something very, very serious in my heart. Wherever you are, whether deeper life or that other place, if you do not discover the way, Jesus Christ, Jesus Christ, take away your sins, to make you to have forgiveness, have the peace of God in your life, you'll just be roaming about. But you know, if you'll make up your mind, and you'll say, this Jesus, the Savior of sinners, I want him to save me, and you forsake your sins, you forsake Satan, you forsake all the evil habits in your life, and you say, this night, I give my life to the Lord Jesus Christ.
Jesus Christ,
the Lord will save you. He will deliver you. All things will pass away. All things will become new. Right now, I'm going to tell you to do something serious. And please, do it seriously. I am going to ask for those who really want to follow the way. Those who want to be free from their sins. And you are going to indicate and you are going to confess those sins. And after that, I'll be praying for you to be healed. But we must settle the sin problem first. I told you I was going to really teach you. I have taught you. You need to discover the way. Jesus Christ. The Savior.
And in young,
Jesus Christ.
Jesus Christ.
The Sanctifier.
And after in you are saved. Jesus Christ,
Jesus
the
Christ.
Baptizer in the Holy Ghost, after you are sanctified.
And you are
the one that will hold your hand. Lead you straight into the very presence of God.
And
I've shown you the way. It is now for you to walk therein. To give your life over to the Lord. And to say, I give myself to the Lord. And you do it seriously. Not like little children. You know, sometimes we say those who want to give their lives to the Lord, raise up your hand. And you raise up your hand. And then tomorrow again you come for the meeting. And those who want to give their lives to the Lord, raise up your hand. You raise up your hand again. Next week you come to the Deeper Life Bible Church.
Those
who want to give their lives to the Lord, raise up your hand. You raise up your hand. If you are taking that same GC exam 5 times 5 years, you are a bad student. If you want to get form for GC ordinary level, come and take the form, you take the form. Another year again, you take the form. You're on GC ordinary level for 10 years, what's happening to you? Raising up your hand for salvation 10 years, 5 years, 10 months, every time you want to give your life to Jesus Christ, ordinary level, GC spiritually, raise up your hand. You raise up your hand, something is wrong with you. If you want to be free from headache, raise up your hand. Today you raise up your hand. If you want to be free from headache, tomorrow you raise up your hand. If you want to be free from headache next year, you raise up your hand. Is a headache your customer? But tonight, if you really mean business, that you want to be free from sin, free and free completely. I told you the day I became free. I even told you the time I became free. And that was the day I prayed for salvation. I didn't come the following Sunday. On the 12th of April, 1964, and prayed for salvation again. On the 19th of April, another Sunday. Pray for salvation again. I got it. And I knew I got it. The ticket to the heavenly city. When I paid for my ticket to come to Calabar here, I didn't go to the airways again and buy another ticket again. When I got one ticket in my pocket, if you want to go to the heavenly city, you want to be free from sin, make up your mind. Once and for all, this is the way. I want to follow the way. Just once and for all, and the Lord will set you free. Sin will be removed in your life. You will be forgiven. The peace of God will settle down. The joy of salvation will be in your soul. You'll be singing your way on. You'll say, I know I am saved. All my sins are forgiven. All my sins are taken away. It can happen to you tonight. It can happen to you tonight. If you have been in any secret call, you will have to come out. Don't worry about what they will do against you. I will pray for you. And no matter what it is, they cannot touch you anymore in Jesus' name. You have been in familiar spirit called. A person in familiar spirit call cannot say he's born again at the same time. Don't deceive yourself. I sing in a gospel church in the choir, don't deceive yourself. Let's be serious tonight. Come out of your sin. Come out of the familiar spirit call. Come out of juju worship. I have heard, I have known, I have seen the way, then follow the way. I want you to bow your head. And I want you to close your eyes. Tonight is a decisive, a great night. The devil is watching you. If you do not own up for Jesus Christ, you are declaring for the devil that you are on the side of the devil. But today, as you have known the way, Jesus Christ, the Son of God, you want him to set you free from all your sins. You want anointing to set you free from the guilt of your sin, from the bondage of your sin. And you want your sins to be forgiven, your sins to be taken away. Where you are, I want you to begin to confess those sins to the Lord. Confess those sins to the Lord. You just tell the Lord that you know that you are a sinner. You tell the Lord that you know that you are a sinner. This is the time to pray. This is not the time to be looking around. So I want you to close your eyes and really pray to God. The sin in your life, confess them. The sin in your life, confess the sin. And tell the Lord, forgive me. Forgive me. I'm fed up going about. I am fed up beating about the bush. I want to be saved. I want to be saved. I want to be saved. All your sins confess. All your sins just take away and hand over to the Lord. Men and women, you ought to be praying now. This is not the time to be looking around. If you are in a secret cult, praise the Lord, you are coming out. If you are in a secret society, praise the Lord, you are coming out. If you are in a familiar spirit cult, praise the Lord, you are coming out. Any sin in your life, confess to the Lord, forsake them. Once and for all, not confessing every day and going back into the same sin, not just forsaking them every day and raising up your hand for salvation every day. Do it once and for all. Do it once and for all. Do it once and for all. Now if you are there, you want to be saved. You want to be really born again. Really born again. You want all your sins to be taken away. You want to have the forgiveness of God in your heart. You want to be totally free from your sin. Where you are, just raise up your hand where you are. That means if you have not been born again before, if you do not have the assurance your sins have been forgiven before, and you know you really want to be free. You don't just want to be playing religion. You want to be really free. Free from your sin. Free from the bondage of sin. And you want to do it once and for all. Once and for all. If you do not have the assurance it is settled in your heart and you want it right now, you can raise up your hand. Decide. Come away from the devil. Turn away from all your sin. Those of you are raising up your hand, I want you to really make up your mind that tonight is going to be the night. You will not continue in your sin. You will not continue in your lying, in your fornication, in your immorality, in your fighting, in all the evil in your life. You want to give your life to the Lord. And you want the Lord to make a definite change in your life even tonight. Wherever you are, just raise up your hand. Raise it up very well and mean it in your heart. Don't be ashamed of Jesus, lest he will be ashamed of you. Don't be ashamed of declaring for Jesus, lest he will be ashamed of declaring to be your Savior. If you are raising up your hand and you are inside, can you just stand up on your feet? Only those who are raising up their hands, who want to be free from their sins, you want to make it a definite time to be free. A definite time to be free. A definite time to be free. Free from your sin. As you're standing, you tell the Lord yourself, when we get saved,
It's something that is done and we have the assurance of it. Not that we're getting saved every day, getting saved every day, getting saved every day. We get saved once and for all. Then we begin to live a victorious life. So just tell the Lord as we're standing up, I want to keep this experience I'm getting tonight. Tell the Lord where you are. Be definite about it. Be definite about it. That you will not go back to all those sins. That tonight will be the last time you'll yield yourself to all those evils in your life. That God will forgive you. That God will change you. I'll pray for you now. As you believe, all the guilt, all the condemnation, all the things that you have done, God will forgive. God will give you the peace. Jesus is the way. Jesus is the way. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray for all these who are standing up, those who are raising up their hands, those who want to be free from their sins. Lord, I pray, you set them free in Jesus' name. Father, I pray that you will deliver them. All the guilt of sin, all the condemnation for sin, you will take away in Jesus' name. Father, I pray that all the guilt, the condemnation that have been in their hearts before will not be there in Jesus' name. Give them the assurance that today you have done it. Give them the assurance that today the joy of the Lord, the joy of salvation is now in their hearts. Give them the assurance of their relationship and fellowship with you. But I pray that you will keep them free from today. Thank you, Lord, because I know you have answered. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Keep on standing if you are standing. The counselors will give you some cards. Keep on standing if you are standing. The counselors will give you some cards. You'll feel those cards. Where we go. And just this month and last month, God has led us to very many places and the Lord has been moving mightily. And whatever you need, sir, the Lord is able to meet them. You're sick, the Lord can heal you. You're oppressed by the devil, the Lord can deliver you. And the Lord will do it in Jesus' name. Whatever your problem is, just want you to bow your head and close your eyes. If you're sick in your body, just lay your hand where the sickness is. If the devil has been oppressing you at night, just place your hand on your chest. If the devil has been troubling you in the head, you can put your hand there. If you brought anybody having mental problems, you can lay your hand on such a person. And if there's anybody you brought who is lame or is blind, just lay your hand on them. God's power is here, and what he has done in other places is able to do here. So just bow your head, close your eyes, and lay your hand on the place you have a problem. We'll pray tonight.
And tomorrow you'll come and give your testimony. Father, in the name of Jesus, I bring all the requests of these people before you. I'm asking for those who are sick, having pains in their body. You pain, I command you, come from their bodies in Jesus' name. I pray for those that have problems in their stomach, in the intestine or kidney. I pray right now that you deliver them from the problems in Jesus. I pray for those who are having diabetes. You sickness of diabetes, I command you, come out of their bodies in Jesus' name. Lord, I'm praying for those who have gone to the hospital and the doctor has given them x-ray and told them they have a terrible, incurable disease. I pray right now that incurable disease come out of the body in Jesus' name. Those who have been tormented by wicked spirits, evil spirits, oppressing spirits, I command those spirits now, in the name of Jesus, in the blood of Jesus, I command you, evil spirits, come out of them in Jesus' name. Lord, I'm asking for those who have been tormented by mammy water spirit. Those who have married, and the spirit will not allow them to have children. And the spirit will be having something with the women in their sleep. Right now, I command